Today's topic of discussion is cardiac conducting system. This topic is included in your module 7 of human anatomy and physiology syllabus. The paper code or course code is EMLT 201. The conducting system of the heart is responsible for generation of autorhythmicity. You know that the autorhythmicity power of heart is essential for maintenance of the life. After birth to until death, our heart is able to generate its own impulse continuously. This impulse is essential for maintenance of the blood flow within the heart and out of the heart. The impulse generator system of heart is divided into several branching parts. Generally, these components are located within the muscular portion of the heart. There are five components. Number one, sinoatrial node or SA node. Number two, atrioventricular node. Number three, atrioventricular bundle of this. Number four, right and left bundle branches. And number five, that is Purkinje fiber. The whole components of your cardiovascular system, conducting system of the cardiovascular system, are essential in two aspects. Number one, impulse generating response. Number two, conducting response or propagation response. Both of them are essential for autorhythmicity property. The SA node or the sinoatrial node is located at the junction between superior vena cava and inferior vena cava part. This is the primary entry of the superior vena cava within the right atrium. From SA node, there are three branches which can divide the current conducting system into three parts. One branch is responsible for conduction of current towards the left atrium, left bundle branch, which is also called left bundle branch. Number two, these two muscle fibers are directly responsible for conduction of the current towards the next part or towards the next part of the atrioventricular node. And number three, third part is responsible for conduction of current towards the posterior part of the heart. SA node has the beating power of 60 to 70 BPM. This beating power is very much essential for production of the current at the first time. This SA node fiber is also called pacemaker. Why? Because pacemaker has the ability to produce pace. Sinoatrial node has the ability to produce pace at the first time. After that, SA node is directly connected towards the atrioventricular node. This is the nodal system which is located at the junction between atrium and ventricle of the right part of the heart. It has the ability to produce current about 60 BPM pace. That is why this fiber has two roles. Number one, reception of the current from the SA node, and number two, in generation of impulse at its own pace. Number three, that is atrioventricular bundle. The atrioventricular bundle has the ability to produce current from the eddy node, but also it has the ability to produce current towards the lower part of the heart. Bundle of these is responsible for propagation of current towards the lower part of the heart, and this fiber is located at the septal region of the ventricle. Ventricular septum is the area of conduction of the current. Bundle of these has no ability to generate impulse, but propagation of impulse is the only function. Next, atrioventricular fiber is directly divided into two parts, that is bundle of His. Right and left bundle branches of bundle of His are responsible for propagation of current towards the last part of the ventricle, left and right ventricle. And the last is subendocardial Purkinje fiber. These has the fiber which have the ability to produce current, and number two, propagation of current. The power is about 35-40 BPM, which is very much lower than SA node and AV node. But very slow amount of current can be produced at the last area of the fibers, and directly the impulse is propagated or transmitted towards the ventricular muscle surface. This is the overall concept of cardiovascular conducting system. I hope you have understood this concept clearly. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comment box or in the online class also. Thank you.